vibrant community of friends. We lived in a Palestinian refugee camp called Yarmouk, and I was teaching English. I'm an English teacher, among other things. I was teaching English to Palestinian refugees and Iraqi refugees and Syrians. And I was also studying Arabic at Damascus University. Josh Batal is also detained with my fiance, and he is a very good friend of ours who came to visit us in Damascus and planned to stay with us for a while. And then I had a week off work, my teaching job, and we decided to go to northern Iraq, which, contrary to most information, is a burgeoning tourist industry, and it has a tourist infrastructure. And it's often referred to as the other Iraq because it's semi-autonomous. It was made a no-fly zone in 1991 to protect the Kurdish people from Saddam Hussein, from his genocide. So northern Iraq is not a war zone, and it is actually, no American has ever been killed there or kidnapped there in many decades. So we went there to learn about Kurdish culture, to spend a week in another part of the Middle East. It was my plan to try to go to every country that I could in the Middle East, every country that it was safe and possible for me to travel to, so I could get the widest and most diverse perspective of an incredible region that has changed my life. And so I do this talk a lot. I talk about what happened to us, and I'm used to giving this kind of background, but it's not really what I'm here to talk about today. If there are people here that don't know all the details of Shane and Josh's egregious detention, they're completely innocent of any crime, and they have been given absolutely no due process. They've now been held, like I said, for nearly 2 years, and they're finally going to have a trial date, we hope, on July 31st, which is the two-year anniversary of their detention. So it's a really important time to garner more support. I hope that everyone here goes to our website at freethehikers.org,